everybody, welcome in. Let's talk a little THT, Talen Horton-Tucker, dynamite. A lot of people are very, very high on him, myself included, and one NBA scout in particular thinks he can hit a very important milestone if he wasn't a Los Angeles Laker. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com. Make sure you subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget, come check out our Flick group. It's a ton of fun. We're talking Lakers basketball there all day, every day. All you got to do is use the link in the description down below. All right, so according to Bill Oram of The Athletic, one anonymous, as always, NBA scout, told him that he thought Talen Horton-Tucker could average 20 points per game if he was on a bad team, like, say, the Oklahoma City Thunder, perhaps the Charlotte Hornets, the New York Knicks, any of those bad teams, that if he was on a bad team, THT could put up 20 points per game. That's the story. Now, is that accurate? I think it's a yes, and I think it's a resounding yes. Now, it's not a perfect stat, but when you go per 36 minutes, right now, in a tiny sample size of just four games, I know that's not a lot to go off of. But in that time period right now, Talen Horton-Tucker, per 36 minutes, is putting up 21.7 points right now for the Lakers, a team in which his usage rate isn't that high because he's playing with guys like LeBron James, like Anthony Davis. So you could imagine if he was playing on a worse team where he could have the ball in his hands more, he'd probably actually score even more points. Now, per 36 minutes, it doesn't always translate. Sometimes guys who are only going to play, say, 10 minutes a night will burn a lot more energy in that 10 minutes than they normally would if they were going to play 36. So sometimes the numbers don't exactly work out the way that you like them to when you do a per 36 minute stat. But just for fun, the rest of his numbers would also include 4.5 rebounds, 3.7 assists. You'd have 3 steals and 1.5 blocks. Think about that. 3 steals and 1.5 blocks. Yeah, can you tell that he's got ridiculously long pterodactyl arms or what? This guy is 6'4", and he has a 7'1 wingspan. That is crazy as it is. But then you add in the weight. He's 230 pounds. That means that he is 30 pounds heavier than Kostas Antetokounmpo, who's 6'10". Talen Horton-Tucker's 6'4". He is just a solid, solid guy. Kyle Kuzma is 9 pounds lighter than THT. Montrezl Harrell, who's a physical presence in his own right, is only 10 pounds heavier than THT is, and he's 6'7", 6'8". So THT has got this very unique body type to go with his skill set, to go with the ability to shoot outside, to go with the ability to pass and defend and all these things. He's got the long arms, but he's also so physically strong, and that's what we're seeing allow him to get into the paint and finish through contact. He's one of the few Lakers who can do that, who can really knife to the rim and has the ability to finish over and around players. He has all the crazy scoops with either hand, but he can also absorb that contact because of his physical profile and defensively. Wow, when he gets it defensively, when things really click, I think he could become a very, very good defender in the NBA. Again, averaging 3 steals per 36 minutes already, plus the block shots, thanks to those super long arms. Now, there are a lot of mistakes that he's still making there. We saw it in the game against the Blazers. He made probably the worst defensive mistake that we've seen from him, where he completely left Gary Trent Jr., who was the hottest shooter on the floor, all alone for a wide open shot. Coach Frank Vogel rightly yanked THT, sat him down on the bench, and that'll be a learning experience for him. But it's also a reminder to us that as good as he is, and as impressive as he can be at times, he is also still just barely 20 years old and is still very much learning. But how exciting is this for the Lakers? I think that an anonymous scout might actually be underselling the number of points THT would put up if he was on a bad team. And here he is on the Lakers with all of that talent, on this team that is ready to contend for an NBA championship right now, and they've found this guy in the second round that can really be something moving forward, and I think is going to be a weapon for them this season. Sooner or later, major minutes are going to be coming his way. His trajectory right now is just about straight up, and once the defense, once how he reads the game on the defensive end of the floor catches up to the other parts of his game, ooh, he is going to be a very, very good one for the purple and gold, hopefully, for a long time. But let me know, am I too high on Talen Horton-Tucker right now? Let me know what you guys think. You can hit me up on the Flick app. Again, use the link in the comments down below. Or, of course, you can respond right here on YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe and make sure you're following Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see you.